How to simulate dynamic and connected cables for an animation? How to simulate collisions for dynamic cables? And how to simulate dynamics and collisions with complex or high poly cables or hoses? Let's take a look. So here in Blender 2.90.1, we are up to date with Blender. Let's see the first situation where you need a simple cable. I'm going to rotate this model 180, something like that, and I'm going to duplicate this and move it in the x-axis, like, yeah, about 3 meters, something over here, it's okay. I'm going to rotate this in the y-axis 90 degrees, and I want a cable going from here to here. I didn't duplicate the bolts, there we go. So what I'm going to do is model a little bit this cable. So I have the 3D cursor at the origin of this object, and I'm going to press Shift A, Mesh, Single Vert. Now notice that automatically Blender changed to Edit mode when you add a single vert. Now while I'm in Vertex mode, I'm going to the front view, toggle X-ray, and I'm going to extrude some vertices here, one over here, another one over here, one more, okay, and I'm going to extrude another vertex and trying to have the same situation here. So one vertex over here, another one, two and three, something like that. And now once I have all these vertices, I'm going to select these two vertices or this segment over here and right click and subdivide. I'm going to subdivide, like, I don't know, 32. The more subdivisions, obviously, the more accurate will be the simulation. Something like 32, it's okay. Now we need to assign some vertex to a pin group. So I'm going to create here a new vertex group and call it pin. So I'm going to select these four vertices and assign it to the pin group with a weight of 1. Okay, assign. I'm going to select here, I need one vertex more, so yeah, over here, something like this. I'm going to assign this, and now I'm going to select these vertices that are outside of this object and assign a weight of 0.5 and assign. And now if I go to the physics properties and enable cloth, I'm going here down to shape and enable the pin group. I'm going to give a little bit more room here to the timeline, okay. And if I press play, as you can see, we have this nice simulation going on here. But what if I want to move this cable along with this object? Well, we need to assign some vertices to a hook modifier. So I'm going to the first frame again. So in edit mode, I'm going to select these vertices over here. And an important thing to have into account, I click select on this pin group. I need to add the hook modifier to the same vertices that we have in the pin group. Otherwise, if we don't assign the same vertices of the pin group to the hook modifier, we are not going to be able to move this cable, right? So these first vertices, I'm going to select them and press F3 and search for hook to a new object. And notice that we just created an empty, and this empty is moving these vertices, right? I'm going to do the same here, so select pin group to see which vertices we need to hook, and F3, hook to a new object. Alright, now these hook objects are basically empties. I'm going to select both of them, and with Alt I can change both at the same time. I'm going to choose a sphere and I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Alright, and now I'm going to parent these hooks to the actual object. So select this hook, for example, and Shift select the other object, Control P and keep transform. So now this object is moving the hook, the same with the other, Control P and keep transform. And now if I play the simulation and I move some of these objects, well, this is not working as expected, because if we go here to the modifiers of this cable, we need the cloth always after the hook modifiers. Now go to the first frame, press play, and now if I move this object, I'm going to be moving the actual cable. And we have even this nice simulation of elastic cable. If I go too far, this is like an elastic thing. It's really, really nice. Now let's make the actual 3D cable. And if this happens, you just have to stop the simulation, go to edit mode, move anything and right click to release at the same position, and the simulation will restart with any movement. So now to add the actual 3D cable, we just need to add a skin modifier. This is too thick, so I'm going to edit mode. I toggle x-ray to see what's going on here. I'm going to select everything, and with Control A, I'm going to make this cable a little bit thinner. Now I just need to add a, go to the first frame, okay. I'm going to add a subdivision surface, two subdivisions, okay. And I'm going to enable smooth shading in the skin modifier as well. And now we have our cable, but now we can adjust the cloud properties here. So for example, I'm going to choose, I don't know, denim or leather. Yeah, leather is like more heavier. And what if we want a longer cable? Well, you just have to tweak the shrinking factor. If I go to a negative value, I'm going to add more cable. Or if I go too high, I'm going to add like an elastic cable. As you can see, this is like, yeah, like a rubber thing. In this case, I'm going to go to a negative value to have a nice bending cable here. And that's it. You have a nice dynamic cable ready to animate. Let's go another step further, and I'm going to call this simple cable, and I'm going to duplicate this, shift and D, and now I'm going to change a little bit this situation. I'm going to delete actually this cable, and I leave these hooks parented to the object. I'm going to rotate this object in the y-axis 90 degrees in this case, something over here. I'm going to move these two objects to a new collection, and this is going to be simple cable collision, because we are going to see what if I want collisions with objects in this cable. Well, in this case we need a stripe of cloth, so a single mesh with a cloth physics. And to do that, I'm going to select this object, shift S, cursor to select it. I'm going to add a plane, scale it and rotate it in the y-axis 90 degrees and scale it a bit more, move this a little bit more over here. And now I'm going to select these two vertices, go to front view. Actually, I'm going to disable this collection. Okay, select them and move to simple cable collision. Okay, now in front view, I'm going to select this plane, go to edit mode, and I'm going to extrude these two vertices here, one over here. I think I need a subdivision here, so Control R and add the loop cut. Okay, and now the same as before, I'm going to the front view, extrude a new face over here, and now I'm going to move this a little bit more, aligned with the other, something over here. Select the plane and extrude this all the way to here. Extrude, 1, 2, 3, 3 or 4, four, another one. Okay, so now we have this stripe of cloth. I'm going to subdivide all this to half all quads. And now, here, we need to do the same with the pin groups and the hook modifiers. So here in the vertex groups, I'm going to add a pin group, select these vertices and these vertices, and assign a weight of 1, there we go. Select these two vertices and these other two vertices, and assign a weight of 0.5, there we go. Now to assign these vertices to a hook, we can go here, for example, if I expand this, I have the empties here. So I know this is empty 002. So now I have it selected, actually. And I can go here, select these vertices, F3, and hook to selected object. All right, let's do the same with the other vertices. Select these vertices. This is empty 003, F3, hook to selected objects. So now we have the same as before. We need now a cloth modifier, and go to the properties of the cloth, and again enable the pin group. And if I press play, now I have my cloth simulation going on. I'm going to increase the length of the cable or of the cloth by decreasing the shrinking factor. As you can see, it stopped and this is because we need to increase the end frame of the cache. Okay, play again the simulation. So now we have the same situation, right? I can move this where I want. And now let's see how to add the collision to this stripe of cloth. I'm going to add here, for example, a UV sphere. Scale it a little bit. Yeah, right over here and shade smooth. Go to the first frame. And in this sphere, I obviously have to enable collision. And now if I press play and play the simulation, we have this nice collision going on here. So the important value here to have into account is in the cloth properties, we have in collisions here, just after the shape, increase a little bit the quality, something like 4 steps. And if we increase the distance, we will add like a ghost thickness to this piece of cloth. And this is really useful because if I want now the actual cable 3D, let's do that. Go to the first frame. I'm going to add a solidify modifier. I'm going to change the offset to 0, so the thickness will go even from one side to another, and select also even thickness. So this is looking right, a little bit more. And now I'm going to add a subdivision surface. 2 levels will work nice, and the shade smooth. So now if I press play, I have this really nice behavior of this cable. As you can see here, we are playing with the cable and really, really nice. So is this distance in the cloth properties the distance we have to tweak until we have a proper collision here. So now we can move this and play with the cable. I can move this or, you know, and have these really nice simulations. And that's really cool. Now let's go even a little bit more further. And what if I want a really complex cable, like a high poly sci-fi cable, or yeah, a complex cable in terms of geometry? Well, it's actually really easy. I'm going to duplicate these two objects again, Shift and D, and move it over here. And I'm going to move this to a new collection and call it complex cable. I'm going to hide this collection. All right. And here in this cable, I'm going to the modifiers, and I just don't need now the subdivision, the solidify. I just need this cloth stripe. I'm going to change the position of these objects, and this will be useful to see what happens when you change the object. So I'm going to the first frame, I'm going to rotate that 90 degrees and rotate that 90 degrees. So now obviously we have to tweak this stripe of cloth. So what I'm going to do is delete these hook modifiers, and I'm going to delete also these vertices and these vertices. I'm going to select everything and move it right over here and go to the pin group. As we duplicated this stripe of cloth, we have some pin group. I click select. We don't have any. So I'm going to select these vertices and these vertices. Weight of 1, assign. There we go. And now these two vertices and these two vertices, a weight of 0.5, and assign. Now, as before, let's see, we have this empty 004. So I'm going to select these vertices, and we have the empty selected. So F3 and hook to selected objects. And over here, I'm going to select these vertices, select the other empty. We have it over here, parented with this object. Select the empty, F3, and hook to selected object. Remember to place the cloth modifier after the hooks. So now we will have a proper simulation of this cable. Oh, and you can do really nice things like rotate that and make like a DNA thing here. That's really cool. Okay, back to the thing. I'm going to the first frame, and now I'm going to import my complex cable or my high poly cable, and I'm going to be using one of my cables of the hard surface Kitbash packs. In case you missed it for some reason, I'm going to leave over here the links and you may want to take a look on it. So let's see, a nice cable could be, for example, like this hose. it's really nice, or this one, or these cables over here, I don't know. I'm gonna try with this Hoses 6-1, this is the name of collection. So to import this cable here, I just need to drag and drop the blend file and append a collection, and it was Hoses 6-1, if I remember. And yeah, there we go, there we have our collection here. I'm going to move that collection to the complex cable, and I'm going to select this object because it's all parented to this object, alright, but first I'm going to place the 3D cursor here with Shift S, select this object, Shift S, selection to cursor. And now I'm going to scale it and just basically position it over here. So for example, this object could go over here a little bit more like this, and I'm going to scale it in the x-axis. And let's see, first of all I'm going to convert this into a single object because we have here different objects with a bevel. So I'm going to select these objects and press slash to isolate. We have here an object with a subdivision. All right, I'm going to apply it. We have these objects with a bevel modifier. We could leave this as it is. So I'm going to select this object, this and this one, and Control J to join them, and join also this object to this one, Control J. So this is just a single object now. Press slash again, and I'm going to scale it in the x-axis a little bit, something over here. So now we have this hose in, or cable in place. So remember to apply the scale or any rotation you did for this object. I'm going to adjust this bevel modifier, and actually I'm going to apply this bevel modifier as well. And now the only thing we have to do to simulate this high poly cable or hose is to add a surface deform modifier. The target is the plane, so I can select it over here in the outliner, and now we can just press bind. It would take a few seconds, and now if I press play, there we go, we have our cable dynamic. And it's working really nice in terms of performance, as you can see. And the best of all, let me stop the simulation, and I'm going to grab this sphere. And if I press play and grab this sphere, we are going to have also collisions on this cable. And look at this. This is really, really awesome and really useful to have nice simulations of, you know, any hard surface design, or maybe just to position the cable in a realistic way. Maybe you make this simulation and you say, okay, this is going to be over here, so I can bake this object in this position, and there you have it. And remember, you still have these possibilities to go to the cloth properties, just play with the, for example, this shrinking factor. And that's all, look at that, this is really, really awesome. I love these simulations. Yeah, look at that. So in case you are interested on, just play with it and see what happens if you change some values of the cloth. And if you want to explore a little bit more on this, I will be sharing this blend file completely free, also with this hose of my hard surface kit wash pack. And that's it, I hope you enjoy it, take care and have fun.